Welcome back to Teresa's Dead. My name is Teresa and I'm very much alive. I have an awful garbage filthy mouth, so viewer discretion is advised. But if you're not into that or weird shit in general, this is definitely not the place for you. Feel free to X out the video here. No harm, no foul. But I'll remember our time fondly. Hello, babies. Happy Cyber Monday, y'all. First and foremost, please shop responsibly today. Don't get yourself into debt. Felt like that was like a strong PSA. But seriously, don't get yourself into debt. It's not cute. That said, welcome to New Makeup Nonsense Bingo, where the fun never ends. This idea was created by the wonderful, the beautiful, my ham and cheese croissant to my bacon, egg, and cheese croissant, Emily Hanhan, pictured here. We love Emily. Emily created this idea where it's essentially a new makeup release video, except we play a bingo game while talking about new makeup releases and have a couple of adult libations. Now, besides Emily and I making absolute fucking fools of ourselves on the internet, we also have another wonderful creator that joins us in the mix, and that's Audra from Audra at Home. We love a good Audra, as opposed to a bad Audra. In any case, I love Audra no matter how I can get Audra. That said, if you're ever interested in wanting to play this game, along with checking out Emily and Audra, everything will be listed in the description box below. And of course, if you ever want to make your own video, you can, and you should, and we would love that. And we do have a community playlist, so feel free to like drop your videos in the community playlist and bloopity blah blah. Now, with that said, because this is a special Cyber Monday edition, has nothing to do with Cyber Monday, but not a lot of makeup has come out. In the past 2 weeks, there really hasn't been much of anything. So we only have 22 makeup products to talk about. So normally I would be like, hey, this is the possible makeup images that we're gonna be talking about. Here's my bingo card. We're not gonna do any of that. I'm just going to fucking just talk about each one of these products until I have to be removed from this vicinity because someone called the cops on me. That's what we're gonna do, okay? Now with that said, we're drinking a little bit differently today. So I'm actually drinking straight vodka. I'm not doing shots, I'm not doing any of that. It's just I don't have anything to mix it with. I know. I didn't come prepared for this. And honestly, I've been getting kind of a little bit in touch with being an old man lately. And I really do enjoy having, like, you know, sipping a couple of vodkas in the evening. Not a couple of vodkas. Oh God, it just sounds awful. What, I can't. I'm not a drunk. I really am not. It just sounds terrible. But anyway, I've been really enjoying having vodka on its own because there's something about burning my insides gives me so much gratification because I have such horrible days at work. So, love that for me. Anyway, so as always, please drink responsibly. And with that said, this video is sponsored by my toilet because I'm pretty sure that's where I'm gonna end up later. Anyway, without further ado, let's talk about the first makeup product. And that is, I don't know. Oh, yes. Oh, Dior, baby. Oh, Dior. Okay. I think I need a sip for that one. It's so tart. I actually cannot do this with any other one. It's just Tito's or nothing. Oh, I need to stop bringing that to my head. It's really embarrassing. I'm embarrassed for me, y'all. Don't worry about it. Okay, so Dior is coming out with the Forever Perfect Cushion Foundation packaging. Wait, hold on. What? Excuse me? What's going on here? So there's gonna be a limited edition packaging for the new Dior Forever Perfect Cushion Foundation. And there also looks like some lipsticks, which two out of the three lipsticks is like, bitch, I need to have them. They're basic bitch colors. And I've never tried Dior lipsticks, so I kind of want to try them. And apparently this is going to be coming out probably January 22. I love how it says January 2021. Okay. Oh, I see what they did there. That was a weird way of putting December, January 21, 22. Okay, whatever. Anyway, this looks like it's gonna be coming out anywhere probably towards the end of December to January. In any case, the collection is fucking cute. So they have this iconic houndstooth pattern, which, I mean, is pretty fucking adorable. I think that's the Lady Dior bag, which, I mean, Lady Dior bags are fucking beautiful. They're beautiful. However, I don't think I would ever get a houndstooth one of a Lady Dior bag because it just seems so, like, you know what I mean? Like, but a houndstooth compact, I'm on board with. And if it's anything like the packaging that Dior has been coming out with, like the little, like, you know, the puffy packaging, I kind of want it. I've never tried the Dior Forever Perfect Cushion. I've never tried that one. The only Dior foundation that I swear by is the Airflash because the Airflash is fucking great. But I've also been told the Backstage is awesome as well. It's just something that I'm gonna need to have to try in 2022. But with that said, I kind of like this. Depending on availability, I may pick it up. because I'm just that extra bitch and I just want pretty things to look at. What can I say? Sometimes I'm just shallow and I want really nice things to look at. I don't have kids, it's fine. That said, I definitely want to get the lipsticks, at least two of them, because they just look like such good basic bitch colors. Granted, do I have those colors? Probably. But whatever, I just love buying things to buy them. Cheers. So yeah, I don't know. I'm like, I kind of want to see the pricing of these things before I go any further, but I like it. I like it. I'm not mad at it. I actually need to go look at like Michelle's channel. Maybe Michelle can talk me. Well, actually Michelle could talk me into anything. Okay. She could talk me into anything. So maybe I'll just see if she recommended this foundation. And then if she did, I will fucking latch onto it like a saber-toothed tiger. Okay. So, I was just going to say on my bingo card, I'm going to call it, I'm going to buy this. I'm going, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to split it up. I want it or like, fuck, get the fuck away from me. We'll split it like that. So I would totally fuck this. Next. I would not want to fuck this. And why is that? Because it's Morphe. And I just don't like Morphe quality, y'all. It's just, you know, I feel like Morphe had its time back in 2016 to 2018. And my makeup dick never got fully torqued from them ever again, right? I have too much bad memories, I think, with Morphe. That said, this is the, what is this? This is a collaboration with Pony's Makeup. Didn't Pony have another collaboration, perhaps? Oh, yeah. I think it was with MAC, right? I don't know. Someone correct me if I'm wrong here. I don't remember. It was something, though. And I remember it being really cute. Yeah, I never got it, obviously. Did I? No. Okay. I had to think for a second. I was like, oh, girl. No, I didn't. Okay, well, all right, here's the thing. So I wouldn't pick this up because it's Morphe and I just really don't like the quality. However, I have to say, I'm not totally mad at this because one, I love the packaging. I think the packaging is really pretty, although it's kind of stepping on the heels of Lunar Beauty a little bit. So I don't know, Manny, you might want to call them up there. All right, because they're really, really stepping on your makeup dick with that one, but it's still really cute. Okay, so color story wise, it's fine. I'm not mad at it. Like, it's a pretty, like, basic bitch palette. But they're, like, these kind of, like, swirly shades that kind of look like food. And I'm like, ooh, it's a candy. And I kind of like that. I kind of could fuck with that. I don't know. I don't think Morphe has ever done, like, swirly type shades, right? Not that I'm aware of. I don't think any swirl type shades there. In any case, not that mad about it. Not that mad at all. So I think, do I want this? No, you cannot get this. Maybe I can though. No, I can't. I'm not doing it. I don't know why the swirly shades are getting me, but I'm just like, they're so pretty. Like, I've never seen swirly shades. I just got the fucking Huda Beauty palette that has swirly shades in it. Come on, Teresa, get it together, bitch. But anyway, so in this collection, you have the Artistry palette, retails for $36, basically another oversized Morphe palette, but not super mad about it. I don't know, like, I feel like this is the first oversized Morphe palette that I don't feel like super overwhelmed, even though, yeah, no, actually I don't feel super overwhelmed about this. What? Like, I actually don't hate this. So the other thing you get too is Constellation Sky Lip Gelée Trio, $20. And then Constellation Sky Face and Body Embellishments for $7. Things that I had as a child. The same shit that I would find at Eclair's. Or actually, wait, do you remember? I don't know if I'm the only one, but, well, actually, no, I can't be. I'm not special. When I was a kid, I didn't have my ears pierced. Like, my mom never wanted to take me. I think my mom was like 30 something when she got her ears pierced. Cause whatever, it's a whole thing. Anyway, I was 17 when I got my ears pierced, and as a child I was just assumed that, like, you know, it was like, it was a gun and it was gonna fucking hurt and whatever. That's why I never did it. But my mom used to get me, kind of looks like this sheet right here, but they used to have like fake little earrings you used to like peel off and like stick it on your lobe. That's so sweet. I don't know why it made me think of that, but I feel nostalgic now looking at these little fucking stickers that I would never pay for. It's cute, but like, it's kind of stupid. But all right, anyway, I'm not entirely mad at this collection. I think I would not pick it up because it's Morphe and Morphe's quality is like, so I probably wouldn't. But if I happen to be in a mall somewhere, Roosevelt Field, for example, and I happen to stroll by the Morphe store, and I happen to see this on sale, and it has to be on sale, I may pick this up, but it's a lot of maybes. You know what I mean? Like, it has to be a perfect storm kind of a day. And I don't foresee that ever happening, but if it does, I might pick it up. So let's just say, like, I might fuck it. I might fuck it. I might. no, I can't. I can't fuck this. I can't. I can't. I gotta talk myself out of it. All right, no. Don't buy this. Or maybe buy this. I don't know. Do you? Next. What is this thing? Okay, so what is this? Harry Styles is coming out with the brand Pleasing. And it's perfect polish set for $65. You get 4 polishes and 3 alphabets of decals. So you get a perfect pearl, a pearlized white nail polish with a glossy finish, pearly tops, a clear with a subtle iridescence and a matte finish, inky pearl, a pearlescent black with a deep blue radiance and glossy finish, granny's pink pearls, a pearlescent pink with a glossy finish. Perfect pearl polish is $20. The pearly tops polish, I feel like I'm just saying tops and pearly and polish like so many times, that's $20. Oh wait, oh my God, there's so much more. Wait, there's skincare, the pearlescent illuminating serum for $35, and the pleasing pen. Is that another name for a fucking dildo? $30, the pleasing pen. Okay, wait a second. What is this pleasing pen? With a cooling steel roller to refresh lips and eyes. Why would I want that on my eyes and lips? One side is an eye gel, with natural lingonberry, okra, and hyaluronic salt, awakens tired under eyes and helps diminish signs of aging and hydrates. The other side is a demi matte lip treatment with soothing marshmallow replenish lips. There's just so much going on. Okay, so listen, I don't know. Okay, so the actual like little bottles of nail polish, they kind of remind me of like in the future, people who are gonna be playing chess or checkers or anything like that would use these pieces, but inside the pieces are gonna be like human remains. Or maybe like the essence of somebody, you know what I mean? Is that too like out there? I don't know. But like the essence, like this is Grandma Pearl. Literally, it was called Grandma's Pearl. It kind of makes sense now. But you know what I mean? Like it just feels kind of weird, but also feels like it could be an animatronic and then it suddenly realizes it's an animatronic and then wants to kill everybody. I don't know. Like I feel kind of weird about the actual design of them. Like at first I was like, oh, okay. And now I'm like, I feel unsettled. More I look at it. The pleasing pen, I don't like that. I don't like that. That's something that I feel like you have to insert in you. I really do love that they actually have different hand models. I love seeing the elderly hand. Like that's pretty fucking dope. Like I like that. I like being able to kind of see how everything looks, but not gonna lie though, it's, yeah, I don't know. I don't feel like there's anything special about this nail polish. Looks like any other fucking nail polish except in a really weird futuristic kind of packaging that makes me think it's somebody's essence. This is necessarily for me, but like, okay. And the other thing too is that you have the pleasing pearls, which kind of just looks like, it looks like what the Huda Beauty weird tea virus shade, what it looked like before it went into the pan. That's what it looks like. I don't know, this is kind of weird. I think, you know, color wise, like I said, I don't feel like these are super fucking unique, but I would be interested in trying them because I do love nail polish, even though I have no nail polish on my hands. And I like fucking rep for Hollow Taco pretty hard, I would say, in terms of like influencer nail polish. It's usually what I have on my hands. But I mean, I would be interested in trying it because I do like nail polish, but I don't like the initial launch. I would be interested to see what other colors come out in the future and if there are anything that like looks really fucking cool that I need to have. But right now, I kind of want to take a step back and just see how this goes. And I just want to see if this will eventually take over the world. Because I feel like it will. I don't know. There's just something weird and unsettling about it. Also, kind of looks like it's a baseball. There's a lot of things going on here, and I don't know how I feel about it. So I'm gonna say, let's revisit this in the future. Next. Okay. So. Colourpop, our Lord and Savior Colourpop. They came out with the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer collection. Listen, that's probably one of my favorite cartoons as a kid. I love Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Like, it's just the shitty claymation, the horrible voice acting, burr eyes. I love it. I have very fond memories of watching it with my mom when I was a kid, and she would just sing silver and gold all the time. So like a part of me was like, oh, this is pretty fucking cute, but I don't like it. I think it's shitty. I think this is so shitty. It's just like a neutral palette with like, honestly, you know what this palette reminds me of? It reminds me of the fucking Kylie Cosmetics fucking Nightmare Before Kylie collection. That's what this palette is. It's probably, oh my God, I should get it now just to see like if it's the same palette because it looks almost identical. It's that same green and that same red. Dude, just saying, man, this is fucking kind of almost the same. And don't they come from the same lab? So it kind of makes sense, right? my fucking mind's blown right now. Listen, if you get it, you get it. Yeah. Who am I to judge you? You know what I mean? Who am I to judge? But the reason why I don't like it is that there is no representation of the island of misfit toys. Oh, I'm sorry. There's one shade. There was a whole island. A whole island of adorable little toys that nobody wanted. Especially with the elephant with the spots. He was my favorite. I love him. I love him. Honestly, I probably would have bought it if it was Island of Misfit Toys. I think I would have been like, here, ColourPop, fucking here, take my goddamn money. But this doesn't do it for me. The palette looks too eerily similar to Kylie Cosmetics. And I kind of feel like, I don't know. Oh, I'm sorry. Misfit Elephant is a lip gloss trio. You did that motherfucking elephant dirty, bitch. Oh, look at those disgusting. It's not even like, come on. Come on. What about Charlie in the box? Where's Charlie? God damn it. I hate this. I hate this so much. I hate this. No. This is a big old no. Where is Cornelius? Where are my people? North Pole Mushma, Mr. Toys, Elf Practice, Christmassy Time, Gadzooks, Up Up and Away, Full Ready Santa, Little Bop. Nope. Eat. We need a fat Santa. Okay, so it makes me mad because this could have been really cool and they chose to like fuck it up. Every time ColourPop does something. It's like they get a good idea and then they shoot themselves in the foot. Kind of like Hip Dot, except Hip Dot double downs on everything and it really is just fucked up. But yeah, no, this is a no for me, dog. But in the collection, you get eyeshadow palettes, $24. The Luxe Gloss Trios, $24. There's a lip set, which has a lip liner and a Luxe lipstick for $16, or you can get both for $30. Rudolph Lippy Scrub for $10. A lip mask for $10. Humble Bumble Mega Mood Melt Cool Mint Bath Soak, $9. You have some hair clips. The full collection's $120. The PR's $125. Packaging-wise, like, I like the packaging. I could stand behind that. It's just everything else. I kind of just feel like it's a big old pass. So no, this is a no for me, dog. I will not fuck it. Next. Oh, I'm going to totally fuck this. I really want this actually. This is LMR Cosmetics, which I feel like I haven't had something from LMR in so long. This is like my early BoxyCharm days, right? This is the LMR collection, the Encanto collection. And this just looks so fucking pretty. I don't think I would pick up all of it. No, I think I'd pick up all of it. I think I will. I think I'll pick up all of it. There's something about the eyeshadow palette that I really, really like. I think that's really fucking pretty. The blushes are okay. Like the pink blush I'm really drawn to. Like the red one, not so much. I feel like that wouldn't work for me. And the highlighter, I feel like it can, I don't know. It could be a little bit too dark, but I'm willing to take that chance. The lip products are okay. Obviously the Basic Bitch one is more on my speed. And then there's lip liners I don't care about. But the eyeshadow palette is actually really fucking beautiful. But I need to really look at it. I feel like I have this with the Ace Butane Tropical Vibes or whatever, tropical blah 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 blah. That palette, I haven't even played with it yet. Like it literally came out that long ago. I just haven't had a chance to like actually try it and review it. But I kind of want to look at that one in comparison to this because I want to see, like, I don't know. Maybe I already have this and I could kind of skip out. Because I can't remember if I did. I like LMR? I feel like LMR was okay. Like it was one of those brands that like their makeup was fine, but it wasn't anything that I was like, I need to have this. I need to fucking have this. But maybe a lot has changed since then, you know? Maybe the quality is a little bit different. Maybe I should try it. Okay, actually, here's this. Here. Let me know down below if you would be interested in seeing a review about it. Why don't we just do it that way? Because if there's enough generated interest, maybe I'll pick it up. So press the number 33 down below, because 33 club, yeah, club 33, Disney, haha, Disney collaboration. I feel like this has a fucking, I don't even know. I feel like I have so much energy and I love that for me. It's like a runner's high. Okay, so let me know down below. Let me know down below if you would be interested in seeing this, and maybe I'll pick it up. Maybe I won't. Maybe I'll go fuck myself. I don't know. Whatever. Next. All right. Listen, I don't know, but I kind of want it. I kind of want this. Do I really need this? No. We have another Lord and Savior ColourPop. Daddy, welcome home. This is the Smoke and Roses palette. I kind of want this. I kind of want this. There's something about their bigger palettes that draw me in. So I think about the Stone Cold Fox palette. That's a great fucking palette. And I have been actually kind of eyeing the Bare Necessities one too. Do I need it? No, it's just a basic bitch palette, but there's something about it that I kind of want. And this is one of those that I just kind of want. So this one has, you know, mattes and shimmers, and I don't think there's any pressed glitters in it, which makes it even better. I do love me a good rosy tone eyeshadow palette. It's fucking not exciting. It's dependable. The period pants of fucking color stories, but I'm into it. So I kind of think I need to buy this. Kind of thing, I kind of need to bloop, 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 bloop. I think I kind of need this. I kind of need it. And I think I might have to. It's not even being tipsy or anything. It's just, I literally, my brain is going faster than my mouth. And I'm like, and I can't talk. And I'm sure people are like, yeah, whatever you fucking love. And today I say, go fuck yourself. All right, anyway. I want this. I kind of really want this. And I think I might pick it up. And it is Cyber, it's Cyber Monday. You'll see this on Cyber Monday, but technically I'm filming this on Black Friday. So I think I might need to buy this. And I also need to stop caressing my titties. Fuck it, I'm gonna buy it. I'm gonna buy it, I'm gonna buy it, I'm gonna buy it. I'm gonna buy it. And the other reason why it's staying in my head, my lovely subscriber Dana, who I love and fucking adore, sent me an email that was like, listen, Amanda from Makeup Just For Fun, which I mean, seriously, Amanda could fucking sell me anything ColourPop, is like, hey, these are the best. You should think about getting it. I'm easily talked into this stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna go buy it. I'm actually gonna buy this right now. So let me go buy this right now. Hold please, I'm gonna go buy it. Because Mama needs to have this. And Mama will make a review when it comes in 6 weeks. So I'm sure nobody will give a shit by then, but it's fine. It's fine. So many people tagged me in this and they're like, did you fucking will this into existence? Oh, shit me. Okay, so our other Lord and Savior Hip Dot is out here in these streets with yet another collection. And listen, I think people are gonna be surprised, but like, I don't hate this. I think this is actually probably a first to see like a Hanukkah collection. And I'm talking about the Rugrats Hanukkah collection. I'm not buying it. Based on my experience with the fucking board game palettes from Hip Dot, I will never buy a Hip Dot palette ever again. But who am I to fucking say otherwise to other people? You know, maybe you like that kind of formula. It just wasn't for me. That said, it's so weird. It's so strange, but at the same time, it's like, I think it's actually pretty fucking cool to see a Hanukkah release. Like, that's cool. But it's just sad that it's Hip Dot. It's just sad that it's Hip Dot, that's all. Anyway, so you have the eyeshadow palette. It's like a little 9-pan palette that retails for $24. A Tommy and Angelica double-sided gloss for $16. A Rugrats Tommy blue sponge for $10. And then you have an Angelica and Chucky face sheet mask for $10. The sheet masks are terrifying. I think out of everything in this whole collection, like the palette's pretty cute, the sponge is cute, even the lip glosses are fine. It's the fucking face mask that is terrifying. Do you imagine having a Chucky on your face? That's terrifying, oh God, I hate it. I'm actually not mad. Like, I think the whole presentation of it is pretty fucking cute. The only thing, like I said, is pretty suspect. Is the scary fucking sheet masks. But other than that, like, this is pretty fucking cool. And I have to say, like, it's just nice to see not just Christmas. You know what I mean? Like, and it makes me wonder if this is going to be kind of like the start of seeing more holidays kind of like roll into it now, right? So maybe we might get a Kwanzaa palette next. That's pretty fucking cool. So I'm excited to see where this is going to go trend-wise. The wind is howling tonight. Howling. But yeah, I'm not gonna pick this up. Actually, let me know down below if you do pick this up, what the quality is like, because if it's anything like the fucking game, the board, I keep saying game board palettes, the board game palettes, it's a no for me, dog. That shit still gives me nightmares. No. Next. Actually, you know what, too? Before I even go into the next one, if any of y'all do get the whole collection, can you please send me a scary DM of you with the face mask on? I will treasure that forever. Okay, next. Oh, I like this. I really, really fucking like this. And it's from a brand called She Glam. Is She Glam from Shein or something like that, right? Yes. Okay, okay. I actually have never purchased anything from Shein, nor have I ever purchased anything from She Glam. And I heard some mixed things. I heard that some things are really fucking cool, like their last... That was really low, that plane. I have heard some really cool things about, I think their last collection had like multi-chrome or something in it. And I was kind of like tempted with that one because I heard some really good stuff about it and then I just kind of forgot about it. But this one though, I fucking love it. I don't know, there's just something really fucking cool. I love the artwork. And listen, I am a fucking slut for astrology shit. Fortunately, I'll have to stop saying Year of the Ox soon, but damn, bitch. I love when I can find a Libra palette. And let me see, where's my Libra? Where you at, baby? The Libra palette's okay. It's all right. I prefer the Virgo palette. The Scorpio palette's pretty fucking cool. Sagittarius is a no. Meh. Let me see, wait. Which of the palettes I would get? Because I actually would get quite a few of them. I would get the Capricorn. The Pisces is kind of cute. The Taurus I would absolutely get. Because that just looks... so fuck. Actually, no, wait a second. The Taurus kind of looks like the fucking vintage rose palette from Give Me Glow. That's why I'm kind of getting obsessed with that. But maybe I should get it though. All right, anyway. The Gemini one is pretty fucking cute too. Leo is adorable. Virgo is great. I mean, I would still get Libra just because I am a Libra. But I don't know, like, I wanted more. But I feel like this kind of is Libra. That didn't make any sense. I mean, I literally made no sense with that one. I'm precious. I kind of want this. I kind of want this, but I don't know. But I'm going to think about it. But I kind of want it, and maybe I'm going to get it. We're going to put a pin in this. But let me know down below if anyone has actually picked up anything from She Glam, and whether you like it or not, or you hate it, or whatever. But I have heard some good things. I've also heard some kind of, like, meh stuff as well. So I'm kind of like, I don't know, like, I'm waffling back and forth like a true fucking Libra. So I don't know. But if you are interested in me checking it out, let me know down below by saying... 55. So 33 is Alamar Cosmetics. Glad that I remember that. And 55 is She Glam. Cool? Awesome. Next. Oh, hi, baby. This is from Mira Beauty, and it's actually, where the fuck is it? It's right in front of me. It's actually right in front of me. I just got it in the mail. Have not swatched it yet, but I did take a picture of it. It's very, very beautiful. But now I need to swatch it, though. Ooh. Oh, hello. Oh, hello, friend. Okay. Oh, this is really, really pretty. Oh, I don't know if you could see that. Ooh, ah. Basically look like I have kind of like a Pepsi ball thing going on my hands right now, but this is really nice. It's very pigmented. But then again, we all know that swatches only tell a part of the story, but this is pretty nice. Anyway, I'm gonna be doing a review on this in the future. I have quite a few different indie palettes that I've been meaning to make reviews on and stuff like that. So kind of expect that in the future, but I like Mira Beauty. I think they're fucking adorable. And actually, if you have ever been wanting to try anything from Mira Beauty, highly recommend their Greed palette, fucking phenomenal. Use the code garbage. You can get some money off and that's fun. Also, it's an affiliate code, which means I do get a small kickback. So just a heads up there. I love Mira Beauty. This is really cute. I really do love kind of this icy color story. It's, I feel like very perfect for us going into winter. So I like it. Anyway, expect a review on this in the future. And yeah, next. Here's another brand that I love. Now, Alien Cosmetics, it used to be Alien Cosmetics. Now it's Unearthly Cosmetics. And it's so hard to say I love Unearthly because I'm like, they've just been introduced as Unearthly, so I'm used to saying Alien. But I love the brand regardless, whether it's Unearthly or Alien, whatever, it's all the same. I have been loving their eyeshadow palettes and their highlighter palette, chef's kiss, fucking weird and amazing, just like me. So I'm obsessed. That said, they did release a line of lipsticks and they look like such fun, grungy colors. Some of the colors, don't get me wrong, they're not my cup of tea because I wish I could be like that bold and amazing and have the confidence of have the confidence of Josh Hartnett's hair in the movie The Faculty, but I just can't pull it off. All right, I just can't pull these colors off, but on most they look absolutely beautiful. But anyway, I actually have heard some really good things about them. Karen Harris, I think, just did like all the swatches on her IG stories. Like, she literally popped out a baby, which, by the way, congratulations, Karen. She's an adorable little baby. Usually babies are kind of like, Karen's baby's fucking cute. really is. Karen's baby's adorable. Anyway, I have to give Karen like a lot of fucking snaps, a lot of props, a lot of credit, and like fucking round applause, everybody, because Karen pushed out a baby and got back to fucking work by showing and swatching and doing everything that Karen does great, you know? So I remember she showed all the colors or whatever on her IG stories and they look good on her, shit. But like, I wish I had the confidence. I just don't. They're pretty cool. If you've ever been interested in wanting to check out anything from Unearthly Cosmetics, I do have an affiliate code with them. It's garbage. You can save, I think 10% off your order or something to that effect. You can save money and that's really all that matters. And yes, it's an affiliate feed, so I do get a small kickback. So hey, thank you for supporting me if you choose to do so. I want to say aliens so goddamn badly. I love Unearthly Cosmetics. They're great. I just, they're really awesome. And they have been just such a joy to get to know. So any hoosies, we're going to keep on keeping on. Cheers. Next. Oh, bitch. Okay, listen. I love me some good indie makeup. Y'all know me. And I love Terra Moon Cosmetics. I love them with my whole fucking being. And they're releasing actually new shadows for Black Friday? Halloween. For Black Friday. And they're just beautiful. And I haven't purchased anything yet from Terra Moons. So these new shades from Terra Moons. And they look absolutely fucking beautiful. So I'm gonna try my best to pick these up if they're not sold out. Plus, I kind of want their 40 pan magnetic palette. That looks fucking good too. Don't know if it's still available. I will definitely go check that out. I haven't had a chance to go pick these up yet, but I'm planning on doing so. I love their chameleon shades. I think they're probably some of the most unique formula I've used. And the shifts on these are just like making my makeup dick sing. It's singing for everybody. And I'm so fucking excited to try these babies out. So yes, I'm on board. I love it. I'm obsessed. Can't get enough of it. So I just hope to God that they're available in stock. But if they're not, on the bright side, Terra Moons does have really, really great sales throughout the whole year. So rest assured, they will be mine one day. But hopefully it's today. Next. All right. So the next thing is from Jouer is just a sleepy brand, y'all, okay? Just a sleepy brand. This is the Radiant Translucent Soft Focus Hydrate and Set Powder. Soft, silky, translucent, pearlized, universal pressed powder. You know, for a universal pressed powder, it looks like it could be potentially a little bit too dark for me. Actually, maybe not, because the Blur Powder from Chantecaille looks like it should be dark. I don't feel like it looks dark on my skin. But that said, I do see like there's kind of like a pearlescent kind of glow on the finger swatch there. Okay, maybe it's just a bad photo. Okay, it's a bad photo. Fucking trend mood with the goddamn bad photos. Anyway, retails for $28. It has hyaluronic acid, vitamin E, vegan, blah, 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 blah. This is gonna come out December 3rd. Okay, here's the thing. I'm happy to see that Jouer is like starting to like do stuff, right? Because I feel like for a while there, they were like stuck in 2018 and then they just like never evolved. And then like, they kind of just like died. So I'm kind of happy that, you know, they are like rising out of the tomb and they have bestowed upon us Easter eggs and new makeup products. And so I'm kind of curious to see what people have to say about this. But, you know, I don't know, just in thinking about like Jouer's products in a whole, like all their eyeshadow palettes I decluttered because the quality is, it's all right. It's less than okay. I always enjoyed their face products and their highlighter. That's amazing. So maybe I would be interested in picking this up. So maybe I might fuck it, but I want to know more about it and I want to see actual reviews on it before I decide to take the plunge and make the commitment. So I think we're going to put a pin in this one, but happy to see them fucking come back and do something. You know what I mean? Like, it's been too long. Yeah, okay. Yay. Next. Listen, I have a hard-on for Viseart lately. I really do. All their new palettes have been fucking fabulous and fantastic. And I fucking highly recommend checking them out. Even the tiny little fucking, the little ones. The ones that came out, the little ones. They have like little 4-pan palettes. Those have been really wonderful as well. I have to say, like, I never really like fucked with Viseart in the past. But now I'm like, I really enjoy their quality. I just think they're fabulous. And they're palettes that are just like, if I were to be commuting back into the office, they would be like my go-to palettes because they just make such beautiful, basic bitch color stories. But they do have sometimes like that pop of like color in there that really just, you know, takes it from a boring basic bitch to like an end with a twist kind of a palette. And I appreciate that. And I've been really enjoying their formula as of late. So I don't know, like I really, really do enjoy them. This one looks so goddamn good. I know that I'm going to be receiving it. So if you're interested in seeing a review, I'll be more than happy to provide one. I love satisfying you babies. I really do. Oh God, the shit that comes out of my mouth. That's gonna put hair on my chest. But I love it. I love it. This is the Petite Pro Etoile. Oh, I think that means star, right? I think that means star. I think étoile means star. There's the one thing that my mom taught me. Étoile means star in French. And I'm pretty sure I'm butchering the shit out of that. I love when my mom comes over because I feel like I usually just practice my French with her. And my mom was very, well, she's no longer really fluent in French, but she used to be very fluent in French, I think in high school and stuff like that. And then over the years, she kind of lost it. When I was a kid, I wanted to speak French. So she bought me like this little book and it was a bear. The bear taught me how to speak French. And I used to only know how to say like, the only thing that sticks with me is, and this is totally wrong, and I know I told this story before, but it's, et toi, est-ce que tu, no, no, wait. Say it with confidence. Et toi, est-ce que tu parles français? No, je n'ai pas français. Je n'ai pas anglais. Which basically says, and you, do you speak French? No, I don't speak French, I speak English. And anyway, anytime my mom comes over, I feel like I have to do that. Which I'm pretty sure she's probably like, why are you trying to fucking speak French? You know you can't. And I'm like, I know I can't. That or, je suis un pan. I am bread. Or je suis un petit crab. I am small crab. All right, anyway, let's just say I can't wait for this. That was pointless. I can't wait to fuck it. Next. I'm so sorry. I feel like all of this is a waste of time, but actually I want to line it up to lipstick. So ColourPop, back at it again. We have more ColourPop palettes to satisfy our ColourPop needs. We have the Ticket to Dreamland and On a Whimsy, which are two palettes exclusively sold at Ulta for $18, as well as a brush set and a Fresh Kiss lacquer and a holiday color sticks. I don't know, a bunch of like holiday shit, I guess, popped up on Ulta. And honestly, this does nothing for me. This does nothing for me. There's like maybe one green shade in the Ticket to Dreamland that I'm like, ooh, bitch, I could fuck with that. But beyond that, it's just like the same kind of color stories that we see time and time again. And then of course, the On a Whimsy palette. The two browns in the middle kind of look identical, so I'm gonna say no. And this is probably the shittiest ColourPop collection to come out in a hot minute. I don't know, like, I felt like this could be better. You know what? In a way, I kind of feel like this should have been more for spring and not so much for winter. I think maybe I would have, like, a different feeling if this was April, but this is November, so no. Anyway, sorry, ColourPop, you didn't have me this time. Next. Oh, hello. Oh, Too Faced. Hello, baby. Okay, so Too Faced is coming out with the Too Femme eyeshadow palette, which I hate butterflies. I hate them. I fucking hate them. I hate that they're all over the packaging. And this is, so in this collection, you get a 14 pan eyeshadow palette and a butterfly blush. I thought it said hardcore and I was like, oh damn, like they're stepping it up with like NARS names now. Hardcore lipsticks and then a Better Than Sex mascara. Okay, so the hardcore lipsticks, no, no, I'll pass. I'll pass. There's nothing about that looks cute. I don't like them. The Better Than Sex mascara I think is beyond overrated. The blush, I do love a two-tone blush. I feel like that's probably just overspray on top of it. But even with the stupid butterflies, like, it's not bad. It's not bad. Now, the eyeshadow palette, I have to say, is definitely, I don't know. I kind of feel like, and this is going to kind of sound weird, but it's different for them. I don't necessarily hate it. I don't think I would buy it because Too Faced is kind of just really known for putting sometimes, like, coconut and shit in their eyeshadow palettes and it fucks my eyes up. So I feel like I have to like look at the ingredients of this one. But usually if this is anything like the fucking Bare palette, then this is gonna fuck my face up. But ironically enough, like the holiday palettes don't. I don't know. Anyway, I don't hate this. Like I applaud them for doing at least something a little bit different and not just kind of having the same like neutral color story, that they're adding a couple of pops of color and they're adding like these kind of marbleized shades that kind of remind me of Game Beauty. So if you've never heard of Game Beauty, they're a fantastic indie company. And they have like these beautiful, I think they're like pearl shades. I think that's what they're called. And they basically look like that. And it's kind of interesting to see that kind of formula within Too Faced, because I'm used to just Too Faced having like the same bullshit, you know, over and over again, except they just have like a different pan embossing every now and again. But I don't hate it. I thought I would. I think the thing that I'm more like visibly upset about is butterflies, because I don't find them to be fucking majestic like most people, okay? They're the devil. So I am interested in looking at this in the future, but I need to see more information about it. I guess I need to see the ingredients before I decide to like pick it up. But listen, stranger things have happened. I'm not above anything. I'm a clown at the end of the day. I do clown like shit. So I might pick it up. I might not. We'll just have to see. Wow, I can't believe I'm saying this. You're growing up, Too Faced. Good job. You're no longer about preteen sex, which sounds really disgusting. Next. Oh, come on, babies. Listen. My child, my baby, my Lethal Cosmetics. They're coming out with a beautiful 9-pan multi-chrome eyeshadow palette. I am getting in PR. Thank you so much again to Lethal Cosmetics. I love your faces. And I'm super excited to be playing with that palette and making a review video on it. But, let's just say, I feel like if it's anything like the multi-chrome that they have in the Berlin palette, I will shit my pants because it's fucking good. So I'm so excited to see this color story and to see that, you know, they're doing something different. And I know the price point of the palette is fucking expensive. It comes out to like $146, but you have to keep in mind it's all multi-chromes, right? So multi-chromes usually range anywhere from like $15 to $21. So to me, it makes sense, like it's appropriately priced. But I'm a fucking monster, so I'm just kinda like, I get it. But what's really nice though too is that you can currently pick up these as singles. So say you just wanted to try one and you didn't like all of them or whatever, you can. And you can get it for like $16.50, which I feel like is pretty appropriately priced compared to like I said, it's anywhere from like $15 to $21 depending on the brand. That said, I do have a coupon code with them. It's not affiliated, so just a heads up there. But if you do wanna save like 10% off your order, just use the code garbage and it'll save you some money. So if you've been interested in wanting to check it out, feel free. But rest assured, I'll be having a review on it. I will give you all the full fucking details on this baby because this just looks too fucking beautiful. And like I said, if it's anything that what I think it's gonna be, I'm gonna be very excited. Everybody in Queens is gonna hear me yell. Everybody. Next. Oh, what is this? This looks exciting. Oh, I'm a fucking moron. I ordered these. I was like, whoa, what is this? This is Glow by Auric. So this is Samantha Robindahl's line. I never picked up any of these little smoke reflex. So when the brand first launched and stuff, the only thing I picked up was the Luminizer. I think that's what it's called. Whatever, the liquid highlighter. And that is fucking fantastic. Like fantastic. I have both Morganite shades, like the old one and the new one. They're both wonderful. I love them. I think they're one of the best liquid highlighters ever. And it's just one of those things that just looks so alien slut and beautiful on the skin. And it just makes you look so healthy. Like you take care of yourself. And I love that. I love fucking faking it until I make it, baby. And like, I love that that product can do that for me. And it will definitely be in like my best of beauty shit because it's just fucking really beautiful. That said, I just didn't really get interested in the fucking iPod thingies because I was like, I'm not really gonna use them. But there was something about these two that really just fucking just got my goat. That means, but it got my goat. And one is like this beautiful cranberry shade and the other one is a beautiful olive shade. And I mean, yeah, they're like fucking basic Christmas colors and like they're nothing super special, but at the same time they look special. I don't know. I'm excited to try them. Expect a review whenever the fuck they arrive, but I kind of like them. I kind of like them. And I'm hoping that I really like this kind of formula. I'm not like super keen on doing like kind of creamy eyeshadows. Listen, I'm old school. I like just powder eyeshadows, but I'm not above it. So I hope that this formula is very easy to use and it makes sense to me, and I don't have a fucking issue with it. I think that's the thing that I'm nervous about, but I shouldn't be nervous. I don't know why I'm getting anxiety about it. I don't even have it in my hands. Anyway, I'm excited to try these out, and I cannot believe how I didn't realize that I already purchased these. Yeah, okay. Mama needs to slow down. Next. Oh, we already pulled this one. Moving on. This is the Encanto collection. Moving on to the next one. What is this one? I feel like we have all the indie ones here in one shot. Okay, so the next one is from It's Belle Cosmetics. I don't, this one doesn't sound super familiar to me. Oh, no, 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 no. I have seen this brand. I have seen this brand. I've never tried it, but I have seen this brand though before. Now it's starting to fucking come back to me. All right, so basically they're coming out with this very beautiful like jewel tone palette. It's called Dawn of Fall, and the pre-order already happened November 18th, and the shipping at the end of November, beginning of December. This palette retails for $45. Oh, you can actually use the code Karen Harris. Use the code Karen Harris for money off, y'all. Use it. But okay. That's why I fucking know, because Karen. I've seen Karen, I think, either swatch this or talk about this or something. We all love Karen. That's why it looks familiar. Okay. This palette looks interesting. It looks very, like, deep jewel tones, and I'm not mad at it. I actually talked about this, like, briefly in my Melt Cosmetics video, which you'll see this week. I really love, like, these kind of beautiful jewel tones, and I've really been, like, drawn to them. Did I say that in this video? Earlier in the day, I did the Melt Cosmetics video, and I don't even know anymore. I don't even know what planet I'm on. All right, I can't remember if I talked about this here or there. Everything's bleeding together at this point. Anyway, I was saying at some point today that I really like these jewel tones because I think they're really beautiful, and I don't know, just something about them that kind of just makes me excited. And this looks really interesting. So I need to go refresh my memory to see what Karen said. But I imagine Karen probably really likes this. So I need to refresh my memory and go check out Karen's videos, or just, I'll fucking hit her up on Marco Polo and just be like, yo, tell me everything about this. Love you, bye. Love your baby, she's so cute. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. Because this looks really pretty, but I need to know more information about it. But yes, I would totally, totally fuck it. We're fucking. Next. Oh, hello, Menagerie Cosmetics. Okay, so Menagerie has, ooh, these polar light, so Menagerie Cosmetics is coming out with these polar light highlighters. Okay, interesting. They're very pretty. One is like more yellow, so I don't know how that's gonna look on me. I feel like that might just not be so good. But the pink one looks like it could be my cup of tea. These look really pretty. I've actually never tried any highlighters from Menagerie or kind of any face products, to come to think of it. I've only tried the eyeshadow palettes and I've enjoyed them. The last one I got was the Annette palette, and the Annette palette was fantastic. I've always wanted to try like the blush palette because I love that little bear that they always have, like the little bear palette. It always looked really cute, but I just never had a chance to try it. So maybe this weekend I'm gonna go check out Menagerie Cosmetics, maybe pick up this pink highlighter because it looks really pretty. It looks reflective. It looks slutty. The kind of highlighters I like, which is that slick alien slut look that I absolutely adore. So this looks really cute. Plus it has a little bear on it and I love it. I love a little tiny bear. It's so cute. Actually, what is their Black Friday deal? Are they having a good deal? They probably are. Let's just say I want it all. I don't know. I'm going to look into this more. Oh my God. Look at those little highlighters. Fuck, they're sold out. Damn it. Okay. All right. I'm going to have to keep my eye on this one. Looks like everything is sold out. I mean, good for them, but fuck for me, right? Shit. Okay. Everything's sold out, huh? I'm going to have to put a pin in this and come back to it. Next. The next palette is from Clarity Cosmetics. Oh, and this is actually launching on Black Friday, so this is launching today. Y'all will see this on Cyber Monday. But this one looks actually really pretty. So this is the Magic Lamp palette, and this looks fucking adorable. I have to say, like, out of all of them that have come out, I think this is by far the fucking coolest looking one. And I definitely am gonna try to pick this up if it's still available. But I don't know, there's something, like the shade Genie is like, oh my God, it fucking has a hold on my heart. That one and Magic Carpet and Set You Free and A Friend Like Me and Happy Ending and Make a Wish and Street Rat. Okay, so all of this, this is actually really fucking good. This is really like a nice representation of Aladdin, allegedly. I imagine it's probably due to copyright, whatever, so it's called Magic Lamp, and okay, I get it. But kinda, yes, can fuck with all of this, and I'm gonna try to pick this shit up. Please tell me it's available still, hold on. Holler. Okay, all right, it's available. So I'm gonna actually go pick this up and I will have a review of it in the future and stuff. But this one looks really fucking cool. That genie shade is fucking killing it and selling it to me. So I need it, I need to have it. It's a got to have item that I got to have now. Okay, next. Oh yeah, I could fuck it. My brain, y'all. All right, I think, oh, we're on the last one. We're on the last one. That fucking flew by. We're on the last one, kids. So let's have a little bit left in here. You know what's so funny? I realized I should have had a toast or something and I didn't. So let's just pretend we can just toast this part. Here's the swimming with bow-legged women. That said, Divina Cosmetics is coming out. And by the way, that's from Jaws. So I hope people don't get offended by that, but it's Jaws, my favorite movie of all time. Just saying. Okay, so Jaws is coming out. Multi-chromes. Divina Cosmetics is coming out with new shades for their Black Friday event, which I talk about in my Black Friday video. So I'll link it up in the corner if you're interested, which you're probably not because you probably already know about these sales anyway. But I'm super excited for this new collection. I can't wait to fucking get it, to play with it, to just rub it all over on my body. And I'm so fucking excited because I love their formula. I love their multi-chromes in particular. Like, they're just some of the most beautiful jeweled multi-chromes that I've ever used. And their quality is top notch, and plus, like, I love the owners. Like, maybe I'm biased. Like, I just love everything about Divina. I think they're fucking fabulous, and I'm excited to see this new collection. So, and I love that their Black Friday sales is probably one of the best sales that is out there because they always have everything like discounted at a really good price, and all like their multi-chromes, everything is just so fucking beautiful. Like, I love them. So, with that said, if you are ever interested in wanting to check out the brand, I do have a code with him. My code is. I was about to say my code is Divina. I need to eat something. My code is garbage. So if you're ever interested, there you go. It's affiliated. And that is so violent. But listen, I'm tipsy. I'm having a good time. I love this. Like, I feel really good. And yeah. Wait, I didn't end that. Let me end this first and then I could talk about how I'm tipsy. And yeah, so with that said, that is fucking makeup bingo, which we didn't really play makeup bingo. It's just, will I fuck it or won't I fuck it? let me know actually if you like this kind of a format, because yeah, maybe once in a while we could throw a format like this into the mix, because this was fun. I had a good time. I am not too drunk. I am nice and tipsy. And now I just can't wait to eat more leftover turkey. So I feel like that's a win-win for me. But in any case, I hope y'all enjoyed this and welcome. Goodbye from day two of deadness. Definitely go check out Emily Hanhan and Audra from Audra at Home. They're wonderful creators and I'm thankful for them. Okay, if we're gonna do Thanksgiving-y stuff. Yeah, Teresa, sure, you're not drunk. What are they saying? Oh yeah, I'm thankful for them. Honestly, I mean, I know, I'm thankful for them, and I'm also thankful for y'all for continuing to watch me just be stupid. I really appreciate it, and just thank you for, well, just thank you for everything. I just love you. Y'all know I love y'all. I just do. And yeah, with that said, let me know what you're actually shopping on Black Friday. What did you pick up? You know, like, what's going on? What's the haps? Give me the 411. Let me know, because I love hearing from you. And with that said, I want to say thank you so much for watching. I truly appreciate it as always. Feel free to like, comment, hit that subscribe button. It's free. And hit that bell icon for notifications of all my future posts. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, Patreon, to all my beautiful, wonderful patron bubbies. Thank you so much for keeping this delicious, disgusting, filthy, trashy, vodka-filled, gross, but also turkey-filled garbage boat afloat. I couldn't do it without you, and I love your adorable little faces. If you want to know what is currently on my face, everything will be listed in the description box below. And I'll see you, little turkeys, later. Please remember to shop responsibly, and listen, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!